Thanks for joining me this Friday, the 6th of June. I'm Grady Wolf, market analyst with Bell Direct, and this is our weekly market update. Uranium stocks have been on a tear this week following Meta's announcement of a 20-year agreement to purchase 1,121 megawatts of electricity from Constellation's nuclear facility in Illinois to power its AI movement, with supply set to begin in 2027. With growing demand for cleaner power, why are the Magnificent Seven and many other corporations diving into nuclear power now? What does this mean for supply and pricing of uranium? And how will this impact you as an investor? Well, let's dive straight in. This marks the second deal of its kind to enter the market, with Microsoft announcing a 20-year agreement to purchase electricity from the Three Mile Island nuclear power plant in Pennsylvania recently. Although that facility is currently inactive, plans are in place to restart operations by 2028. Google and Amazon have also inked to similar long-term nuclear power agreements in recent times, as the Magnificent Seven as a whole moves to cleaner sources of electricity to power the intense requirements of the AI revolution. The primary driver behind this trend is near zero carbon footprint of nuclear generated electricity. The move is a very strategic one, aligning with the global shift towards clean energy. Nuclear energy has become one of the key beneficiaries of the AI-driven spike in electricity demand from data centers as well. Nuclear power generates minimal carbon emissions, making it a very valuable component in efforts to decarbonize electricity supplies. For companies like Meta, these deals also support diversification of energy sources and bolster long-term power reliability. This wave of adoption by tech giants like Meta and Microsoft is creating very strong tailwinds for listed uranium producers, particularly Boss Energy, which holds a stake in a uranium mine in South Texas. Shares in Boss Energy rose 8% in just one session this week. Additionally, the development of new nuclear reactors is driving significant growth in uranium demand. Uranium is the primary fuel source for most nuclear power plants, with around 10% of the world's electricity currently generated from uranium nuclear reactors, amounting to over 2,500 terawatt hours, according to the World Nuclear Association. Approximately 60,000 to 67,500 tons of uranium annually are currently required to power nuclear reactors globally. This amount is anticipated to grow to reach over 83,000 tons by 2030 and over 130,000 tons by 2040 due to 70 nuclear reactors currently under construction around the world and a further 100 reactors in the pipeline for construction in the coming years. What this means for the spot pricing of the commodity is what Bell Potter's analysts expect of the price of uranium to peak around $130 per pound in 2026 before moderating around $95 per pound beyond FY29. Bell Potter Resources analyst Regan Burrows said, "We see supply tightness peaking around the end of this decade, and typically utilities contract 2 years out from the delivery, so hence why the spike comes through in FY26 to 27. As an investor, how can you capitalize on the tailwinds for uranium driven by the AI demand surge for nuclear power? Well, Bell Potter has a buy rating on Boss Energy, Paladin Energy, and Deep Yellow for the reasons that follow. Bell Potter rates Boss Energy as a buy rating for strong cost performance, reliable delivery, and growth catalysts on the horizon. 3Q FY25 unit costs could beat estimates at $33 per pound versus $40 per pound, which is what we were expecting, with steady production and sales at $84 per pound. Backed by $63.7 million in cash and $165 million in inventory and investments, and with CY25 expansion ahead, Boss offers upside supported by uranium fundamentals and a South Texas mine interest. The target price for Boss Energy remains at $4.85 per share. Bell Potter also rates Paladin a buy after a strong third quarter FY25 with production, grade and recovery beating forecasts. Despite some weather issues, operations have stabilized and sales exceeded output at $69.9 per pound. With limited near-term guidance, the stock offers strong value and a target price has been raised to $6.50 per share. And Bell Potter maintains a buy rating on Deep Yellow for its strong uranium leverage and phased Tumas project strategy. Despite final investment decision delays, early infrastructure and financing progresses are underway to reduce risk. With $227 million cash, solid project economics, and adjusted valuation at $1.45 per share, there's upside potential as the uranium price continues to rise. Locally, from Monday to Thursday, the ASX 200 gained 1.54% as 9 of the 11 sectors appreciated, led by financial stocks rallying 3.14%, while real estate stocks rose 2.04%. The winning stocks were led by Lynas Rare Earths, surging 18.89%, Brickworks climbing 18.72%, and James Hardie gaining 13.1%. And on the losing end, IDP Education tumbled over 54%, while Domino's Pizza and Nufarm lost 10.26% and 10.51% respectively. On the broader market index, the All Ords rose 1.51%, led by Hyperion X soaring 34% after the company announced a major contract win with the US Department of Defense, or DOD. IDP Education at the other end of the All Ords posted a 54.9% drop on uncertain outlook for student enrollment numbers. The most traded stocks by Bell Direct clients this week was DroneShield. Clients also bought into BHP, Fortescue, Ramelius Resources and Life360, while taking profits from our big banks in CBA, Macquarie, Westpac, ANZ and NAB. And the most traded ETFs were led by Vanguard Australian Shares Index ETF, Vanguard Australian Shares High Yield ETF, and Vanguard MSCI Index International Shares ETF. On the economic calendar front next week, we may see investors respond to Westpac consumer confidence data for June and NAB business confidence data for May out early in the week, with the forecast of a decline in both readings amid market and macro uncertainty. On a global scale, key inflation and trade data out of China will paint the latest economic recovery picture out of China early in the week, while later in the week, the key US inflation and PPI data will reveal the early impacts of tariffs on US inflation so far. And that's all for this Friday and week. I hope you have a wonderful weekend and happy investing.